a fence, a wall in front of that, which I'll do in a minute. So back to the large hike, and then there's another tree, the big tree now. It takes up. This one's a monster. So I'm doing ultramarine, lemon yellow, pine's grey, right up to this house there. Nice and dark, but leave plenty of gaps. I'm just going to flick a few. Branches in there. Also, as well as scrape a few out, I'm just going to stick a few in as well with the rigger. Nice dark colour, and where I can see the holes, just flick a few more in. Maybe just continue some of these lighter ones that I did with a fingernail. I think that'll do, but I don't know how to do it. Like I said, you know, in front of this building there, we've got a little wall. So I'm going to burnt umber, ultramarine, and I'm just going to put in the basic shape of this wall. So it goes up there and then something across like so. We'll switch the plastic card and just pull that down a bit more. And I'm just going to scrape. Quite far away, so I don't want to do these too big. And that sort of comes up to the corner there, and then this that figure across. I'll make sure I get these in before the paint starts to dry. It doesn't matter if you just leave bits too much. Like the bottom there, I haven't got that in, but it doesn't really matter. I can cover that up with some grass, which is what I'll do now. So I'm just going to go into raw sienna, lemon yellow, raw sienna, lemon yellow, just a touch of paint's grey. I'm just going to pull that down slightly. And the grass actually starts up there. Now we've got a path coming along here, so I want to preserve some of that whiter area. Just keep varying the colour. A bit more blue. Touch of red. So the path goes along there. And we've got a bit more grass along here. Clean the brush, get some lighter areas in, I think. Raw sienna, lemon yellow. Ultramarine.